So now we want to make a function to print the content of the file in reverse order. So for example, consider this file over here, and let me remove all the new lines. So we only have these characters, okay? So we want to print these characters starting from the last character and to the first character. So what we'll do, we will use fseek to move the FPI over here. Then we will get this character using fgetc. Now remember that whenever fgetc is executed, we will increase the FPI. So the FPI will now point to this character after 8. So let's suppose we are using seek end. So we will start moving from the AOF. So the first time we will move minus 1, right? And then fgetc will increase the FPI. So we are back at the AOF. And remember, we are using seek end. So we don't care where is the FPI right now. Now, to get to the character 7, we have to move minus 2. So minus 1, minus 2. We get the character, so the FPI is increased, and now we are at 8. So if we are using fcurrent, this will be a little bit complex. Whenever we use seek end, we don't care where we are, and we will move starting from the AOF. So now to reach 6, we move minus 3. So minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So as you can see, this can be a variable. It starts from minus 1, then it is minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and this will continue until fseek gives us minus 1. When fseek returns minus 1, this means that we exceeded the file from the left. So we know that we need to stop. Okay? Now remember that this way does not have backslash n, alright? We only have one line. So let's do it. So first of all, we need a character to store the value of fgetc. So character c equal to 0, for example. And now we want to control the FPI as long as we don't exceed the left side. So while fseek, we want to move the FPI of our file, we will define a variable I, for example, and each time we will move from the end, so seek end. So while this is different than minus 1, the loop will be executed. So let me define this variable I, so I is equal to minus 1. As we said, the first time we want to get to the last character, so we'll use seek end and move minus 1, right? Now, every time we use this variable, after we use the current value, we will decrease it. So the second time, I will be equal to minus 2. So we will move to the character before the last character. And then we will decrease I. Now, the third time, it is minus 3. So we get to the character before the previous one, and so on. Alright? Now, inside the loop, we need to get the character. So c is equal to fgetc of f. Now, fgetc increases the FPI, but I don't care, because over here we are using seek end, not seek current. So this over here will not affect our condition, right? Now, we want to print C. So let's print F, and let's print a character and C, right? Now let's build and run, and look. First of all, we got 8 and printed it, then 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and after 1, fseek returned minus 1. So we got out of the loop and we closed the file. So everything is working correctly. And remember, the index of this character, minus 1 gives us this character. Minus 1 gives this, then this, then this. Alright? Now, let me go to the file and let me add a backslash n over here. Now, to get from this line to this line, we have to subtract 2, not 1. Because to get from the first line to the second line, we add 2, as we saw before. So, let me save the file and over here, run the program again. And look what we have. We have 2 backslash n. We printed it 2 times. Now let's go over here, put another new line, save the file, close this, run the program again, and now we have 4 lines. And this is wrong, because over here we only have 2 lines, right? As you can see. So to fix this, as I said, each time when there is a backslash n, we need to subtract 2, not 1. So let's say that we get the character, and the current character is backslash n. So let's say if c is equal to backslash n, then we need to subtract 2. So if you make I minus minus over here, we will decrease I, right? So build and run and have a look. Everything is now working. So let me go over this. When you first open the file, we are at the first character. Then we are using fseek f minus 1 seek end. So now we are at the last character before the AOF. So suppose that the backslash n is over here, alright? So now to get from this line to the line above, we have to subtract 2. So let's see what happens. I first of all was equal to minus 1, and then we decreased it. So now it is equal to minus 2, right? So look at this. C is equal to f get C, and now it is backslash n. So we get backslash n. So this condition is true. So we'll decrease I. So now I is equal to minus 3. So first of all, we decreased minus 1, and now we are decreasing minus 3. So as you can see, now we are subtracting minus 2 more than the previous time. At first it was minus 1, and now it is minus 3. So what will happen? We will get from this line to the line above it. And then we will print the character, which is backslash n. Perfect. Now we will re-execute this. So we will move from the last character, minus 3, to the line above it, right? So now we are over here. Get the character, it is backslash n. So I minus minus. So when we executed this, I is equal to minus 4. So now it is equal to minus 5. So previously it was minus 3, and now it is minus 5. So as you can see, we are subtracting 2. So we will get to this line. And we read it backslash n, so we print it. So as you can see, we printed the backslash n each one time, and this is correct. Now we will re-execute this, and as I said, last time we get over here. So the character that we are going to read is 8, and we will print it, and this over here will not be executed, and we will subtract only 1. So now we'll get to 7, and I will only be modified over here. We will make one time I minus minus. So now we get to 7, then 6, up until we reach 1. Now you might be asking, when I was teaching you this, I told you that imagine the backslash n is over here, right? But now when we are working, we suppose that backslash n is over here, and we get to the upper line, and whenever we read the character, we are actually reading 8. And yes, you have the right to think about this. So what I want you to imagine, backslash n is over here, and to get to the previous line, we subtract 2. Alright? So like this, and this. And whenever you are reading like this, imagine normally that the backslash n is over here. Alright? So, now we have two new lines. So let's add one more line, and now let's say 098 for example. Save the file, and let's run the program. So have a look. 098 is printed in reverse, so 890. And then we have two new lines, perfect, and then we have this. So now everything is working. So what's important over here is to avoid using C current, because each time F get C will affect the FPI, and this will make things more complex. And also, whenever we read backslash n, we need to subtract 2, not 1. So we modify I over here in order to get to the upper line. Alright? And by the way, this is the easiest way I found in order to print a file in reverse order using fgetc. Alright? So don't worry about other methods. This method is enough. So great job. This is it, and I'll see you in the next video.